Hi, Mattias here with another episode in the Bitwig Ambient Mastery course. Today I'm gonna introduce you to the soothing world of pink noise. But first, what is pink noise and why is it so calming? Pink noise is a type of sound that has equal energy across each octave. Unlike white noise, which can be very harsh and annoying, pink noise is softer and more balanced. Many of your natural sounds like wind, rain, rustling of the leaves all contain the characteristics of pink noise. That's why pink noise often feels so natural and relaxing. A typical use case of pink noise is meditation and sleep, because pink noise can frankly help you sleep better and make you relax more easily. Why pink noise is so great for meditation and sleep is that it's superb at masking out distracting or disturbing sounds. And it helps to drown sudden and sharp noises, creating a more stable and calming auditory environment. And finally, it's also been suggested that pink noise actually can enhance memory and cognitive function during sleep. Right, so now when you know the benefits of pink noise, we're gonna apply some noise to our ambient song. So let's take the tour. Okay, so in our ambient track, we're gonna add some kind of noise instead of like an ambient audio recording, like we did in a previous episode. And there's a few different ways that we can create noise in Bitwig Studio. And the easiest way is probably to use the test tone device. Right-click and create a new instrument track, and press the plus sign and search for test. And if the test tone device doesn't appear for you, it may be because you have some filter going on here, and we have currently the all instruments filter. So we need to select the browse by everything instead, or we can also browse by audio effects, because the test tone is an audio effect. So it's a good practice if you don't find the device. Just press this search for everything. So we'll add a test tone device, and you can see by default it's gonna output a test tone, a test note. Right, so the test tone device is just a sound generator device, and aside from this sine wave, it can also output other sounds. So if you press the waveform select, you can select triangle, square, saw, up, saw down, Dirac, and also white noise and pink noise. So first let's select the white noise, and before I increase the volume here, we're gonna add an equalizer, the EQ plus after the device, so we can see the sound spectrum. So let's expand the view for EQ plus, and there we have our white noise. As you can see, since it's a ramp, we have less power in the lower frequencies and increasing power towards the higher frequencies to the right side. And if we instead select the pink noise, so the pink noise will give you more of a straight line because we have equal power in the frequency range. Yeah, so the pink noise here is what I'm gonna add to the track to give it some kind of nature or like ambient backdrop. And there's of course a few different synths here in Bitwig Studio that can also generate noise, but they won't have this selector to change between white and pink noise, but we can use equalizers to sculpt and shape the sound instead. And that's exactly what we're gonna do here. So let's just mute the test tone track, and let's add a new instrument track, and we're gonna use the FM4 synth to generate our noise. We have this synth sound. Let's decrease the volume quite drastically here, because the noise can be quite loud. And we also need to decrease the volume for the first oscillator of FM4, because we're gonna focus and listen only to the noise generator. So we need to increase the noise level instead. The default setting here for the noise is quite resonant, and you don't want that kind of sharp, harsh sound, especially not for an ambient track. So let's reduce the resonance almost to zero, and instead we're gonna bump the drive a little bit. And we can set this to around 1.6 kilohertz. We need to increase the sustain so we get a longer sound to play with, because we want this to sustain in the background of the track. And we can also bump the attack quite much, and also the release. Now let's play back the track and adjust the volume so we get it to a proper volume against the music. Yeah, so something like that. So now it sounds much more pleasant to listen to this music because, at least to me, we have this like nice ambience to the music. And by default, this is also a monophonic sound. So it's very sharp in the mono field. And let's make the noise stereo, so we have like a wide, nice backdrop. So let's go into the effect slot and search for split. And we want not a frequency split, but a stereo split. So we can add separate devices to the left and the right channel. And in the right channel, you can choose either the left or the right channel, but I'm going to choose the right channel, expand that, and in the slot, we're going to add a pitch device, a pitch shifter. And the default setting. First, we're going to reduce the gain, and we're going to set the mix setting to about 70% and increase this to maybe 2 semitones. Hear that? And at the end of the effect chain, we're going to add an EQ plus. And we'll add a high-cut filter by hovering about the right side, just below the line, and make a press. And just reduce that to around 12 kHz. And add a high-pass or a low-cut filter at around 120 Hz. Maybe a little bump like this too. Next up, let's add a MIDI clip, so make a double-click on the noise track. And extend this clip by hovering above the rightmost top side of the clip and extend the MIDI clip like this. So we get it across a whole chord progression. Make a double click and add a note anywhere on the timeline and extend the note for the whole length of the clip. Like so. Right, so now we can select that clip, press Command-D to duplicate 4 times, so we have it across all these chord progressions. And we can also rename that Command-R noise. Finally, I'm gonna add a very slow LFO to the filter cutoff of the noise, so we have a little bit of like windy character to the noise. So let's add a modulator, the classic LFO. And expand the view by pressing the LFO. Decrease the hertz to maybe 0.10. And press the mapping key and attach that to the cutoff, just a little bit like this. And if you want to reduce the effect of the LFO, you can always just change the amount. So I'm going to increase the release for the FM4 synth here because I don't want like this change to the next note be too obvious. Now, if you notice, if you start to play back your arrangement in the middle of a note like this, by default, it's not going to trigger the MIDI note. But what you can do is click the Bitwig icon at the top of the interface, go to Settings and Behavior tab, and look down here at Resume Playback. There you have the note chase. If you deactivate the note chase and start the playback in the middle of a note, you won't hear any audio because the note is not triggered. So if that happens to you, make sure you have the Resume Playback note chase active. There we go. And if you want a little bit more bite to the noise, or a little bit more like a high end, you can always increase the resonance just a little bit. Yeah, so I still feel we have a little bit of like a gap here when we change the note. Now, you could, of course, just make a one long extended note throughout the whole piece, but we can also fix that by adding a delay. So before the equalizer, in between the stereo split and the equalizer, we can add a delay. Just use the regular delay too. And yeah. We can have it at the default settings. I think that will. Let's solo the noise and playback so we can hear the transition between these two clips. Much smoother. So the track without our background ambience. Yeah, so that's it for this episode. Hope you had a nice time, and let's go and make some noise. See you in the next episode. Bye.